Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no one has gone before.
Captain's log, Stardate 185-21.0.
Alex Soto, LordOfTheJars.com. Hello everyone. No, you're not wrong. This is a screencast of the part 1 of my Iberian Performance Tips post. In this screencast I'm going to show you the effect of Druidy Collection on Ibernate. Let's see it. I've got here a project with two model classes, Starship and Officer. And as you can see, the fields are annotated at property level. We've got here an ID, a lot of fields, and finally a one-to-many without a mapped by attribute on returning an unmodifiable list. Officer is more or less the same, all annotated at property level. And finally, here you can see a test. This test, the first thing that do is creating data. See that in this case we are creating the Enterprise D with its crew, Jean-Luc Picard, William Riker, Data, etc. And then finds in a starship. If you look here, you can see that we are finding by primary key, and a starship by primary key, and committing. So let's run this test. And boom! See how many queries are being executed. First the insert of a starship, then the insert of all officers, and then the insert to a starship officer. This table is in a join table. Remember that we have not annotated with mapped by attribute. By default, Ibernate, if no physical map is configured, uses the join table approach, and this is the inserts to the join table. Then you can see the select by primary key, but see how many queries are executed during commit. You're selecting officers, then you delete the join table and recreate all the relationship. And why? Well, the answer is quite simple, because Ibernate detects that officers collection is a Druidy collection and must recreate all the objects. Even the objects are still the same, have not been modified, but needs to recreate it. See here that we are returning a different instance. So one can say, what can think, okay, if on recreation Starship Officer table is the affected one, let's change it. We're going to create here the map by attribute store ship. Now the many to one part is the owner of the Russian ship. We save it and we run again the test and see less queries, yes, but during commit, a select is executed to. A select to the officers, and you can say, hey, one too many, by default is lazy. Why this select? Well, for the same reason than before. Collections are still dirty. So you can say, hey Alex, remove the collection.unmodifiable list and return the same instance. And yeah, just parallelly. That's partly true, but if we do this, we are broken encapsulation. We're exposing mutable internal state of the object. So if you return the instance directly, you can add whatever you like. So I think this is a very good practice. So you can say, okay, a good practice, but with a select in each commit. Now, exists a solution. See here, a project that's a solution, and see that I only changed one thing. I've changed the annotation place. Now, instead of using property label, I'm using field label. All fields are annotated at field level. One too many, with the mapped by, of course, the identification, all the attributes, and see that officers, the same, all annotated in field level. And now we're going to run the test and see what's happened. See? No query. No problem. So, expect the unexpected. And if you want my personal tip, use field access mapping instead of property access mapping. Thank you very much.
Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no one has gone before. Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no one has gone before.